Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Right, what I'm doing today, I don't want anyone else doing. Please, I am doing this because I get paid to do shit like this from YouTube. I go through this stuff so you don't have to. I'm going against everything I've ever preached about pore vacuums. I have turned down countless pore vacuum sponsorships because I know these are no good for your skin. However, this particular pore vacuum has gone viral sometime last year and then this year again. And this is a pore vacuum with a built-in camera in the tip. So you can see exactly what's going on your nose, wherever you choose to pore vacuum. But it is like magnified by an insane amount. So not only can you see everything that's going on, but you see it so up close. You see every detail and it's disgusting and makes you hate yourself. The videos of this over on YouTube are, I love Dr. Pimple Popper as a person, but I can't watch pimple popping videos. I don't like watching liquids and fluids come out of people. It makes me feel physically sick. So I didn't watch many of these videos. I watched a few and I'm not sure how I'm gonna cope doing this myself. But we always say these pore vacuums are bad for our skin, but why are they bad? You can really damage your skin, you can bruise your skin, you can actually damage blood vessels permanently if you do this wrong and too hard. But you know what, let's not just take my word for it, let's head over to TikTok and look at what some of my favorite dermatologists have to say about this particular pore vacuum. Just to scare myself even further.
I wanna know whose idea it was to put a camera inside of a pore vacuum, as if pore vacuums aren't already bad enough. They wanted to see what was going on inside of them. Honestly, they're okay if they're used on the lowest setting, but I still prefer niacinamide, BHA, and a retinoid to treat this in the first place. Not this again. I know that pore vacuums are super satisfying to watch, but all that redness is inflammation, which can permanently damage your blood vessels. I do not recommend.
Oh no, I can't watch stuff like that. It makes me feel really sick.
I know that you might be tempted to buy a pore vacuum because this looks really cool and it's satisfying, but they're kind of hard on the skin. I don't recommend it. Instead, use salicylic acid or a retinol, and let's avoid
three products that will help keep your pores clean. Use a glycolic and salicylic acid toning pad. At bedtime, apply Differin gel, charcoal-based mask with kaolin once a week to absorb oil and debris.
Okay. So there we go. I honestly can't stomach those videos, but I use niacinamide, I use BHAs, I very rarely use retinol nowadays just because my skin doesn't seem to agree with it. So I'm a little bit dubious as to how much we're actually going to get out of my nose. I also think you're going to see a lot of hairs on my nose. So, okay, here's the thing. I've prepped for this video in the way that I've not exfoliated for a week with using any BHAs or AHAs, any exfoliating acids. I usually will wax the mini hairs. You can't even see them to the naked eye, but I can. So I will usually wax or remove the hairs on my nose, but sometimes that can count as exfoliation. So I've not done that either. So we're going to see a lot of hairs on there, maybe a few blackheads, I'm not sure. So this is really easy to set up. All you do is download the app. Now, you download the app, then you just connect this via Wi-Fi. We're connected. Then you go back to the app and then you press that home screen. And here we are. Oh my God. You know what? Let's just do this. I'm using the tip that they recommend for your T-zone, I believe it is. So we're gonna start on the lower setting. Let's have a look at the nose. See, yeah, loads of hair. I promise you can't see these the naked eye. This is where you can see I'm super oily as well. I have moisturized and done a very basic routine. So hairy on the nose. What is that? How is there such a long hair on my nose? Oh, that was a bit of fluff. Do it this way, look. I'm usually quite blackheady up here. I mean, there's nothing big there, right? There's no giant, there's a few bits there as well. I believe this is the same brand that does the ear wax picker, ear cleaner, where it's got the camera on the ear cleaner. Tell you what, we are just gonna go for it. We're gonna start in the lowest setting. That doesn't do anything. Okay. Oh no. Oh no, that's too strong. That's way too strong. No. Okay, so I'm gonna not let it sit and I'm gonna drag it. I'm not gonna lie, this is quite difficult to use. Uh.
Go on. Go on.
I mean, really, I think what you're seeing there is a mix of my moisturizer and natural oils.
Oh my god, I'm disgusting.
I need to clean this before I carry on. My nose is looking very red. I think I've done a bit of damage up here. I must say the two different settings are very different. You go from minimal strength to what is very, very different, almost what I thought was maximum strength. And then there's another setting that's maximum strength, which I don't think I'm gonna do because that feels very dangerous. How's my nose doing? My nose isn't looking as bad as I thought it was. I've definitely damaged the top up there. Like, that doesn't look good for me, does it? I mean, it's doing its job. Am I enjoying it? Not really, no. Okay, I think we're done. That's gonna be it for me. I mean, to the naked eye, my nose doesn't necessarily look any cleaner or clearer because you can't see this shit anyway. This is like magnifying times, I don't know, 100. I don't know how magnifying glasses work or cameras or whatever, but this, you're just never looking that close to your nose. It now looks like I've damaged the skin on the top of my nose for a while now. And what I'll do is I'll take a picture later this evening and just kind of post it here and show you if it's improved at all. I'm not sure it's going to. So, do I recommend this? No. Does it work? Yes. Can it fuck up your skin? Absolutely it can. I mean, it's fun to do, but when fun comes with danger and the risk of damaging your skin, I don't think it's really worth it, to be 100% honest with you. Was this video pointless? Pretty much, yes. So if this isn't warning enough for you not to use this product, I don't know what is. I don't know what's gonna stop people from using these kind of things. Probably not someone on YouTube advertising it. Well, not someone like me on YouTube showing you how much it pulls out of the skin. But again, it wasn't really worth it. My nose hurts now and no one could see that shit anyway, you know? So you can see some product reviews here and some general light entertainment here. And I will see you over there.